going on, everybody? It's your boy Jefe, your favorite boss videographer and photographer, and we are at episode 1 of Jefe Talks. Today we'll be discussing a little bit of my video tips. We're going to also discuss my journey of me being a videographer and a photographer and a business owner as well. Then we'll lead into our movie review, our TV show review, our video game review, our gas of the day, and then we'll get into our quote by Kendrick Lamar, and it's a very good quote. You're going to love it. My video tip of the day is you got to be creative in this field. You got to be creative when you are being a videographer and photographer, because there are so many different ideas. There are so many people coming up with so many different ideas. Imagine that a big time company is trying to invest in you. And the question they ask you is like, okay, what can you do differently than the next person? And you're gonna have to answer that question. So you always gotta know, okay, what can I do differently than the last video? Or different than that one. Say they had an event previous to the event that they're hiring you for. You look at that video and you be like, okay, that was cool, that was dope. So, but you gotta show some different, because now we got a different baller in the court now. So now you have to make the decision of, do I want to be different or should I give out the same thing that they're giving? Be a little different, because that's what's gonna make you different amongst so many different people. And that's my tip of the day, is be creative and be different. My journey. I'm gonna start from the beginning from my journey, man, like of doing videography and photography. I originally went to a school called Garrett College that was in McHenry, Maryland, in the mountains. Then I left there, transferred to Virginia State University, went there for like 3 years, then eventually found out that wasn't the cup of tea I wanted to be in. And then I moved to Winter Park, Florida, and I went to Full Sail University. And Full Sail was where I got my degree from, and Full Sail is where I got the most videography, photography experience, of course, in the field, because that's what I was majoring in. I was actually able to see like big time cameras, lighting, sound stages, like 30 to 40 people working together to make one film. You know, that might take a couple weeks, a couple days, a couple months, but we made it happen, you know? And that was like one of the best experiences I dealt with. Like, it didn't even feel like school anymore. It just felt as though like I'm here to do something I want to do. I'm paying for it, but I love it. You know, I don't mind paying money for this one, for this school, because like we're actually hands-on. I'm touching the camera. I'm touching the equipment. I'm talking to the people. We're creating something fire. You know, so we are doing all of this. So once we graduate, we know how to do it with another company or create our own company and do what we did. It just, you got to have that experience. So that experience was amazing and that journey was great. And that is my journey of the day. All right, behind the scenes. So one of my favorite shoots, and also a shoot that went extremely viral, was my Virginia State Different Worlds video. But I can't take the credit. Majority, all credit goes to Aaliyah. Aaliyah is a good friend of mine from Virginia State, and she's also my Karojo modeling sister as well. And she hit me up one day and was like, hey bro, I want to capture my graduation video and I want to do something really different. I'm like, all right, cool. What you want to do? She said, I want to do a Different Worlds intro. I'm like, all right, cool. That's all right. That's all right. Let's go ahead and get that going. So I watched a couple of the Different Worlds intros. It was like 3 of them. We picked one of them. Saw it like a million times. And then from there, I was like, all right, I got it. So she riled up everybody that was in her org. So every org that she was in, she gathered enough people to get it done. It was done like crisp. It was done so well. People was there on time. And it was just done so quick. You know, it was great. I did the editing. I sent her the rough draft. I made the critiques that she wanted. After that, bam, went crazy. went viral. I was like, oh snap. She called me, was like, yo, Tommy, do you see the pop that is getting? I was like, I didn't even pee because I was still asleep when she hit me up. Boy, I looked at my phone, blowing up. I'm talking likes after likes. I'm talking repost after repost. I'm like, yo, we balling out of this thing. I'm like, okay, this the one. This is the one right here. So, if you haven't seen the video, I'm gonna show the whole video for the episode. So here's the video of the Virginia State Different Worlds version of Aaliyah Puff. Y'all, that is the video, one of my best masterpieces. Make sure you share it, make sure you like it, make sure you tell everybody about it. And we're gonna head to the next segment, which is our movie review. And the movie that we're reviewing today is the movie Nope, starring Daniel Kaluuya, Kiki Palmer, and directed and written by Jordan Peele. The movie is about random objects falling from the sky, resulting in the death of their father. Ranch owner siblings OJ and Emerald Haywood attempt to capture a video evidence of an unidentified flying object with the help of a tech salesman and a documentarian. My review on that movie, it wasn't bad, but it wasn't good, you know? I would give it probably like a 6.2 because of how the story was not clicking together. The story with the monkeys, sorry, spoiler alert. The monkey story, I didn't understand until maybe the end. And what I got out of it is if you look an animal in its eye, it might kill you. And that's what it was with that movie. If you saw the movie, it was like a bedsheet alien just sucking people in. It and I'm just like, what is going on? And you should have saw it was like a ultimate size king, double king, triple king, full size sheet in the air just whooshing around. I'm just like, what is this? And then before it eats you, it has like 15 layers, just whoosh, whoosh. And I'm just like, okay, like that was dope weird, but I'm like, what is going on? What's happening? So, yeah, my review on that was definitely a 6.2. You can see for your own experience, I wouldn't recommend it. But, yeah, good job, Jordan Peele, but bad job at the same time. But, yeah, that is our movie review. Let's get into this TV show review. And the show I want to do a review on today is called The Offer. That is a show that couple people got me hip to, and I finally watched it. It was a tough show, probably the best show I watched in 2022. One, it displays and shows how filmmakers and producers create a masterpiece and then the stuff they have to do to make it happen, you know? So basically the show is about a producer named Albert Rudy, and he is the producer of The Godfather. And who plays him is Miles Teller, very good actor. I love this guy in like so many different films. Like this guy is really good. So with that, it showed all the stuff that he had to go through to even make this film. For one, talking to the actual writer of The Godfather, you know, to then talking to the actual, you know, person who is screenwriting and producing as well. And then it was owned by Paramount Pictures. So then even talking to them to make sure things were going good with them, on top of getting through the mafia, the Italians, of the just to make the movie something. Because they didn't want it to be labeled as, you know, people who kill people and whatnot. You know, we know you the mafia, but we don't want it to be a movie about it. So it was a very good movie. And it showed a lot. It showed a lot when it came to the stuff you would do to make a good film. How much you would put in to the point where you would take a pay cut. To the point where you would lose everything just to make one film. My boy almost lost his life making a movie. That's how much he knew this was going to be a masterpiece, you know? So my review on that, 20 out of 10 off rip. All right, y'all. Let's get into our game review. And the game we are reviewing today, and it's for the boys, Madden 23. Y'all, why y'all keep buying the same game? It's the same game, bro. The same game, like, with some mini new features. Like, I think when you pass the ball now to the receiver, you can hold it for, I guess, how many other seconds, I guess. And it's like a lob pass or, I don't know, man. It's the same game, same features. If it ain't no holograms in my living room scoring touchdown, I ain't buying Madden. You know what I'm saying? Our game ship, I'm not buying Madden. And then on top of that, the stuff I be seeing on TikTok and Instagram, crazy. Watch some of these clips. Watch this. Like, come on now. Come on now. Wow. Imagine seeing that in a real game. That's crazy. Because you wouldn't. It's not real. What? Yo. That's when I would have threw the controller. It would have been over. It would have been done. Oh, yo. These joints are crazy. It's just like, imagine seeing these in an actual game. Like, this will be insane. Oh, yeah, nah, Madden is insane for these. These are just amazing catches, but, like, it's not possible. I'm sorry. Like, ain't no one dropping them dimes like that. And we got one more clip. Y'all good? Just let y'all know y'all got a this dude was pissed.
All this goofy shit.
He is not happy.
Y'all continue to let goofy shit like this happen. Goofy, I promise you, we loading up that 2K and it's gonna be curtains for Madden. This shit is.
Oh!
Come on, baby. Y'all got to get it together.
Yo. The amount of nonsense I just witnessed. Nah. EA Sports would have got a nasty email coming from your boy, for sure. Or I would have been marching up to the headquarters with a gang of people, would have been like, yo, I want my money back. Or or we need something fixed because this is ridiculous. Like, that stuff would have happened on an online game, or if I would have had money on the line, oh bro, yeah, nah. Mm-mm. Yeah, that would be my last time betting on Madden. But that is your game review, and we're going to give it a 3.5 out of 10 for the nonsense of the same stuff that y'all keep giving, and then the nonsense of these BS plays. So that is your game review of the day. We are at the gas of the day.
Smoke weed every day.
We've been smoking on this whole podcast, okay? All right? It's wedding cake, you know? And it was mad flat because I've been, you know, been doing my due diligence on it, all right? Okay? The bag is hilarious, you know, some buns with some candles on it. Very nice, you know. We always love aesthetics, you know, but we also love effects better. So, wedding cake, 60% indica, 40% sativa. It's a cross between Triangle Kush and Animal Mint. It gives a sweet aromatic essence, fruity flavor, and it's really good for depression and controlling anxiety simulating symptoms. Okay. The effects on it is being creative, euphoria, okay, relaxing, and sleepy. All right. So, if you want to be creative and be a nice videographer, not telling you to, you know, get some wedding cake in you, but I will recommend it, you know. And if you're trying to relax and chill, wedding cake. If you tired, wedding cake. If you want to be like Rue on Euphoria, wedding cake. That's your gas of the day. All right, we are at the end of the podcast, man. But like I said, we always end up with a quote. And then we got a quote from Kung Fu Kenny Kendrick Lamar. And what he said is, I don't want to be something that just comes and goes. I feel him. I want to make my mark in this world. You know, I want people to know who Jefe is. You know, what I bring to the table, what I do. You will always know who I am. You know, even when I'm 6 feet under, I'm leaving a legacy out here. Ain't no just come and go. This ain't just, here's this. Nah, I'm staying. This is Jefe. Okay? So, that's our quote of the day. I don't want to be something that just comes and goes by Kendrick Lamar. And that is our podcast. Thank you for listening. Thank you for watching. Make sure you subscribe to the YouTube channel. Make sure you follow me on Instagram, TikTok, Facebook, all that good stuff. Man, and come back for episode 2. And I'll see you when I see you.